Brothers asked a very important question. He's asked the question that if we follow one particular scholar and then we come to know another scholar has strong proof, so can we change to his view? For example, he's following one particular madhab, then Isa finds in this issue they have strong proof, so should I change? So brother, we have to distinguish between two things, and which Allah knows, which Allah knows everything which is in our hearts. First is, a person is changing for the sake of proof, that this particular scholar has strong proof, I consider him to be correct in this issue, I'll follow it. See, consider this. So many sunnahs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam come in front of our eyes. I can see this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you only look at the topic of salah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna al-abda la yansarifu." A person prays salah and he turns. وَمَا كُتِبَ لَهُ إِلَّا أُشْرُ صَلَاتِهِ. But he gets only 1/10 of his salah. To suha, sumnuha, subuha, sudsuha, kumsuha, rubuha, sulusuha, niswa. 1/9, 1/8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. For different people, different is they get. Now why? How many sunnahs you act on and how much khushu you have inside? How many sunnahs you act outside and how much khushu you have inside? That much reward we'll get. Now I come to know in this issue, so and so scholar has given proof. It's so strong. Now do I leave the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ even after seeing it? Even after seeing the hadith which a scholar is also has put forward. Not that we are ourselves creating new masalas. But a scholar has given this hadith and it's a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ whom we love and follow. And this hadith comes in front of my eyes. And I say, no, I won't follow this, huh? Because this is belonging to that school of thought. So what kind of justice is this? So we should know that there's no such rule in the Quran and the Sunnah that if you follow one scholar, then don't follow other scholars. As Allah says, Fasalu ahla dhikri, ask the people of knowledge. Allah has not said, Fasalu ahadu min ahli dhikri, ask one of the people of knowledge only. Allah did not say, only one you can follow, you can't follow the second scholar. All the scholars are asked. Let's stop dividing them among ourselves. Every scholar is asked, who's following the Quran and the Sunnah? And we love every one of them because we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But here comes another person who's shopper, who wants to look for ease. And he says, I get this masla is easy over there, I'll go there. And this masla is easy over there, I'll go there. But what happens? This is not hidden from Allah Ta'ala. And Allah knows about it. Huh? Allah knows about it. And he cannot make excuse before Allah Ta'ala that he was following proof. See, there's a difference between these two people. There's a difference. A person who follows evidence and he changes to follows another scholar. And the person who's looking at where I can get some easily masla, huh? Then there's a difference between these two, and Allah knows, and the distinction is very clear. Okay, so we find so many examples from the past also, where so many people have taken the opinion of different scholars, and it's common, alhamdulillah. So what happens? These rigid, watertight compartments which people have made of scholars, that this is the scholar I follow and finish. Now tell me, if you were born over there, now his wuzu is gone because he's born in the school of thought. He was born over there, his wuzu would be okay. He lives his life this way, here, there. So by chance, just because he's born here, so just because he's born there. So we say, no, don't look at it this way. We are followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the best thing I think to do.